Hey, Lisette here for Tool Tester. If you want to take your email marketing to the next level with ActiveCampaign, but aren't sure where to start, this tutorial video is for you. Together, we will walk through uploading a contact list and setting up your first email marketing campaign in just a few simple steps. But first, let's create your ActiveCampaign account. The sign-up process is pretty self-explanatory, and there is even a chatbot available for any questions you may have at this initial stage. All you need to do is enter your email address in the sign-up bar and click Get Started to begin. By entering your email address here, you'll be signing up for a free trial, and the great news is that there's no credit card required at this stage. Next, you'll be taken to a welcome page where they will ask for your name and phone number. They'll also ask you three basic questions. How many contacts you want to upload, how many employees are in your company, and which industry you work in. Based on the industry you select, they'll ask you which third-party services you are currently using. For example, if you're working in the e-commerce sector, you can integrate your account with Shopify, WooCommerce, PayPal, and more. ActiveCampaign integrates with plenty of apps, so it's a good idea to set up the integrations you use and centralize your marketing data from the get-go. Next, you'll be asked to set up your password. And as always, it's important to make sure it's a secure password. Remember, you'll be storing a lot of sensitive data within this platform. Thankfully for new users and complete beginners, ActiveCampaign scatters helpful instructions around the page to help you easily navigate your way through the platform. Once you're through answering their questions, you'll want to head over to Settings. Here we can adjust your time zone, personal signature, and language settings. Note that ActiveCampaign supports more than 10 different languages, which is great if you have marketing and sales agents from different countries. Next, head over to the Advanced Settings tab. Here, you'll find settings for authentication, including DKIM, Sender Policy Framework, and Email Domain Verification. It's important that you set these up properly from the start in order to maximize the deliverability of your campaigns. We've added a link to ActiveCampaign's in-depth guide to authentication in the description below, so be sure to check that out. It's also worth noting that ActiveCampaign manages SPF and DKIM for you by default. Therefore, not all of these settings are strictly required. However, we recommend managing them yourself to establish your domain reputation and further improve deliverability. Now that you've set up your general settings and authentication, it's time to create your first list. Later, you can segment your users based on their interests, demographics, purchase history, and more. But first, let's head to the Contacts tab. Click on the Add a List button in the top right-hand corner. Next, you'll be asked to provide the following details. List name. Keep this short yet descriptive. List URL. This seems confusing, but it's really just your website and needs to be added for compliance purposes. List description. Use this field to remind your contacts how you got their details and why they are on this list. Once you fill this out, hit save, and that's it. Your list is ready to go. Now that you've created your first list, it's time to import your contacts. Click on the Contacts tab in the navigation menu on the left. First, you'll be asked if you'd like to migrate your account for free. This is an incredibly useful feature if you are migrating data from an email service provider other than ActiveCampaign. If this is the case for you, we have provided instructions on how to complete this step in our written ActiveCampaign tutorial. I have left the link for you in the description below. Okay, so now that you are in the Contacts tab, you have two options. You can add an individual contact by clicking on Add a Contact, or alternatively, you can bulk upload your contacts by clicking on the Import button in the top right-hand corner. For the second option, you can choose to import your contacts from a file, which needs to be in a CSV format with all the necessary fields, such as name, company, and email address. Uploading a file is by far the easiest option, especially if you are planning to bulk upload. You'll then be asked to map out your fields to ensure that your file's data is mapped correctly. You can also add a tag if you'd like to differentiate this upload from your future uploads. However, that step is optional. Once you've mapped out your user data, select the list you'd like to upload to and hit Import Now. Another great feature here is that you can also import your contacts directly from third-party apps such as Calendly, Typeform, Google Sheets, and many more. Now that your contacts have been uploaded to your desired list, it's time to create your first email campaign. First, click on the Campaigns tab in the top menu, and then simply hit Create a Campaign. Next, choose the type of campaign you want to create and which email list you'd like to send the campaign to. Next, it's time to select the email template type: ActiveCampaign's Email Designer, the classic drag-and-drop designer, text-based emails without images, or custom HTML, whereby you can upload your own HTML email template. For this tutorial, we'll choose their email designer because that's where all the good templates are. There are more than 250 email templates to choose from, all organized into categories such as selling a product, making an announcement, and many more. You'll also have the option to create your own template from scratch with their drag and drop editor. Once you've selected your desired ActiveCampaign template, you'll be asked for your sender details, which will be your name, sender email address, and your subject line. Don't worry if you're still unsure about these details at this stage, as you can always go back and edit this information later. Now it's time to add your email content. Use their convenient drag-and-drop email editor to add images, text, and other elements to your email. You'll want to make sure your email is visually appealing and easy to read. And this is very important, you'll also want to preview it to make sure everything looks good before sending. You can do this by clicking here. You'll be able to preview the desktop and mobile version, but you'll need to pay if you want to see how it looks on specific email clients, like Gmail or Outlook, for example. Finally, once you're happy with your email, it's time to send it to your contacts. Click on the Next button to review your campaign summary, and then click Send Now to send your email right away. Alternatively, if you'd rather schedule your campaign for another date or time, you can do so by switching the Schedule button to On and selecting which day and time works best for you. Thanks for watching our tutorial. We hope you found it helpful. Check out the links in the description for more information, and as always, feel free to write to us in the comments section. Subscribe to our channel for more video reviews like this one, and see you next time.